Good morning, students. Today I am going to take the class for fourth standard and the mathematics for them. Okay, this is the 17th session for fourth standard in mathematics, and I am continuing the exercise 6. Okay, in the previous class we have done the problems up to the fourth one. Now we'll start the fifth question. Okay, what they have given is the weight of one watermelon is the weight of one watermelon is 3458 grams.
One year.
We all know that how many days are there in 1 year? It is 365 days. Okay. Number of hours. Number of hours in 1 day. Okay, how many hours are there in 1 day? That is we all know that 24 hours in 1 day. So we first do the multiplication. 5 4 are 22, carry 0 here. 5 6 4 6 are 32. Sorry, 24 plus 2 is 26. 2 carry 6 again. 3 4 are 12. 12 plus 2 is 30. 14. Okay, 14. Plus, multiply the 2 now. 2 5 are 10. 1 carry 0 here. 2 6 are 12. 12 plus 1 13. 1 carry 3 here again. 2 3 are 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. Add it now. 0. 6 plus 0 is 6 itself. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. 4 number of hours in 1 year, okay, is 8760 hours. Okay, in 1 year how many hours we have? That is 8760 hours are there in 1 year. Okay, next go for the 7th problem. A football weighs 288 grams. Okay, what is the weight of the football? Is 288 grams. What is the weight of 175 such football? We have to find the weight for the now 175 footballs. A football weighs 288 grams. What is the weight of 175 such footballs? Okay, what is the weight of one such of such footballs? Okay. The weight of a football. What is the weight of a football? What is the weight of a football? That is 175 grams. Here I will write it. Number of footballs. How many footballs you have? 175. Sorry. The weight of football is 288 grams. Okay. Number of footballs. How many footballs are there? Into 175. Okay, in this we have to multiply with the 3-digit number. Up to here we have multiplied with the only 2-digit number for 3-digit. Now we have to multiply the three number digit itself. Okay, first you start multiplying with the 5. 5 8 are 44, carry 0 here. 5 8 are 40, 40 plus 4 is 44. 5 2 are 10, 10 plus 4 is 14. Okay, plus 7 8 are 56. 5 carry 6 here. 7 8 are 56. 56 plus 5 57, 58, 59, 60, 61. 6 carry, 1 here. 2 sevens are 14, 14 plus 6. 14 the mind, 6 are fingers of the 4 to 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20. Plus, again, for doing the 3 or 3rd digit number, again, 2 places you have to write there. 1 8 is a 8, 1 8 is a 8, and 1 2 is a 2. Add it now. 0, 6 plus 4 is 10, 1 carry 0 here, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 4 is 14, 1 carry 4 here again, 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 1, 10, again 1 carry, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 2 is 4, sorry, 3 plus 2 is 5.
Chapter 4. Okay, up till here we have completed the
go for the next chapter, division. In the previous year, in the third standard, we have learned about the division, but in that they have given the two digits numbers to divide, but in this they have given the three digit number. In the exercise only I will show you how to do the step by step division. Okay. In this exercise only I will show you how to do the division. Okay, divide using the long division and find the quotient and remainder. Okay, so you want divide using the long division in your notebook. Write the quotient and remainder if any. Okay, this is the first Roman number. In the first exercise, first one, what they have given? 272 divided by 2. Okay, students. Okay, this number we call it as a dividend. Okay, that one, this is the larger number you should take in the middle. 272, and the 2 is a divisor. Okay, from this only we have to divide the 272. Okay, first number, because it is a single digit number, so first you consider the single digit itself. 2 1 is a 2. 2 into 1 is how much? 2. Okay, in this you have to deduct this one. 2 minus 2 is 0. Next you have to take the 7 down here. Okay. Next 7. Okay, 7 is the multiple of multiple in the 2 table. No. Okay, then which is the number nearer to 7? That is 2, 3 is the 6. So 2 into 3 is equals to 6. 2 into 3 is 6. In 7, if you detect the 6, what's the remainder? What it will remain? 6 7 minus 6 is 1. And lastly, 2 is left. Take the 2 down now. Okay. 2, 6 is 12. Okay, 2 minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay, what the answer we have got here? This is the quotient. Okay, this is the quotient. If any number is left here, okay, instead of 0, if we got any single digit number which is not multiple of that number, okay, it is considered as the remainder. But in this quotient, we got the remainder as 0, and the quotient is how much? 135. Rather than resolve that, quotient is 136. Got it, students? Next, go for the second problem. 474 divided by 4. So, in the easy method, if you want to do it, means what is the number they have given? 4. So, write the 4 ones are table beside you. 4 ones are 4. 4 2 is 8. 4 3 is 12. 4 4 is 16. 4, 5 are 20, 4, 6 are 24, 4, 7 are 28, 4, 8 are 32, 4, 9 are 36, 4, 10 are 40. Okay, it is very easy method to do by writing this table here. Okay, 4 is the divisor you have taken here and 474. Okay, first you consider the 4 number. Okay, take it because they have given a single digit, so you have to consider the single digit itself. If they have given in the double digit or the number which is more than 5, okay, we can take consider the 2 digit. But here they have given the 4 which is lesser than 5, so we have to consider the single digit, that is 4. 4 is the multiple. 4 ones are 4. 4 ones are 4 minus this one. 4 minus 4 is 0. Then next you take the 7 down here. 7. So 7 is multiple here anyway? No. Okay. The number what we got more, it should be the lesser than that. So again you have to take the 4 ones are 4. Okay. 7 if you take 4, what will you get? 3. And what is the left here? 4 is left here. Take it down, it is 34. Okay, see your students in the multiplication in this table where we got any 34 here, this 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36. Okay, 34 is between the 32 and the 36. We should not take more than the 34. So we have to go for the 32. So 4, 8 is 32. 4 minus 2 is 2, 3 minus 0 is 0. Okay, what's the remainder we got? What's left here? 2. Okay, it is not divisible in the 4. We got anywhere 2 here, single digit 2. No, we didn't got any 2 there. So, what is the remainder which is not divisible by the 4? What is left? No, that is the remainder. Quotient is 118. Quotient is equals to 118 and reminder is how much? 2. Okay students, got it? Next go for the third one. 672 is divided by 3. Which table they have given here? 3 table. Okay. So, 672 is divided by 3. You know 3 ones are no? Just write the answer. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 9, 3 threes are, sorry, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, 3 sixes are 18, 3 sevens are 21, 3 eights are 24, 3 nines are 27, 3 tens are 30. Okay? 672, 3. Okay, 6, first you consider the 6, we'll get 6, no? 6, 2 is a, 3, 2 is a, 6, so, subtract, 6 minus 0, and what's that, 7 is left, 7 we have to take down, okay, 7 is multiplied in 3 ones are here, no, we got the 6, and 9, but not 7, so we have to go for the, again 6 itself, that is 3, 2 is a, 6, so 6 minus 7 minus 6 is 1 and lastly we have to take the 2 down. Okay, it will become 12. Okay, is there any 12 here? Oh, it is here. Means 3 4s are 12. 3 into 4 is 12. Subtract this one. 2 minus 2 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. Quotient what we got is? Quotient is equals to 224. Got it students? Do you have any doubts regarding this? Next go for the D problem. Which table they have given? 5 table they have given. 475 is divided by 5. Okay, there is this. Okay, 10 5 ones are here. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 6 are 30, 5 7 are 35, 5 8 are 40, 5 9 are 45, 5 10 are 50. Start doing here. 5. 475. Okay, if it is a 5 or else more than 5, then you have to consider the 2 digit. Okay, 47. Is it 47? Is in 5 ones are. Okay, the nearest to the 47 is 45. Means 9 5s are 45. Okay, minus subtract this one. 7 minus 5 is 2. 4 minus 4 is 0. Then only 5 is left. Take it down 5. Okay, it will become 25. 25 is here. 5 5 is a 25. Subtraction 5 minus 5 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. We got the remainder as 0 and the quotient as a, the quotient as 95. Quotient is equals to 45 and the remainder is 0 itself. Next, go for the E problem now. Only two problems are there in this Roman number, and remaining I'll take in the next class. I'll complete these two. This completes your Roman number 180 exercise 1. Okay, friends, and the remaining three problems are there in this exercise. I do in this in the next session, and we will start our exercise 2 also. Thank you, students.